right. Introduce yourself, sir.
My name's Scott Thompson.
And if you don't know him, you should. He was on a show called Kids in the Hall, which was sketch comedy before sketch comedy was sketch comedy. Him and the guys from Kids in the Hall did groundbreaking things for years, and everyone that's come since then has modeled what they've done because of this man and the group from Kids in the Hall. So we're very lucky to have him here tonight, and he got honored tonight with a commie, which, if you don't know, means he's a communist, and he hates everyone in America. So, did you have fun tonight, sir?
Man, it was unbelievable. It was beyond my wildest dreams. I can't believe that we won. I got an award, and I'm so thrilled. I can't stand it.
So, I have a question for you. You're a living legend, people like me. You are.
It better be a dead man.
Yes, it is. But I have a question for you. So, tonight, when you're up there speaking, do you feel the weight of what you've done, or is it still kind of like you have so much more to do?
I feel like I got a lot more to do. Yeah. And I don't feel it as a weight. Like, I feel and it did seem a bit of a burden. And then I just kind of woke up and said, wake the fuck up, you're a kid in the hall. It's a wonderful burden to have. And then it just became, I'm thrilled by it. I love people. If they want to say that that's, if I'm always associated with being a kid in the hall, that's completely fine, because I'm so proud of this.
I have a question, so those who don't know, how did you get affiliated with the kids in the hall?
Well, at the time, I was like, we were kids, and I was an actor, I wanted to be an actor. Like 22, but Dave was like 17, 18, and I was not doing very well. I wanted to be a serious actor, a dramatic. My dream was to be a dramatic actor who was funny and talk shows. And then one day, a friend brought me to a midnight show of the original Kids in the Hall, there were 8 at the time.
Oh, really?
And I saw them, and it was like a voice from God. I just went, I'm going to be in that group. And that was it. Sometimes in your life, you see your path. And that was it. And I just made myself indispensable to them. Next day, I showed up with a bag of wigs, and I never went away.
I have a question for you. Earlier, your partner in the movie, Josh, right?
Josh directed the movie. And he directed this is the third short of me I've done with the Levy brothers.
Okay. And so, obviously very talented.
Very.
But before that, he was saying how you inspired him as a young gay male. For you, was it just like a natural choice just to be out? Because I remember thinking, I had never seen someone just blatantly be as comfortable with who they were about their sexuality as for you.
It was kind of a no-brainer, yeah. Because at the time, as you know, this is the mid-80s we're talking about, there was no doing that. And, you know, like my generation of gay men were decimated by AIDS. So at the time, AIDS was just rampaging through the community. I just come out, I just met the Kids in the Hall, I just started my sex life and my comedy life.
You were so young.
Yes, and I was so freaked out by everything. There was this feeling everyone was going to die. So I thought, what the fuck? I felt I had no choice. Things were so serious, the stakes were so high, that I just went, the only moral thing that I can do is be honest. If I want to be the kind of comedian that I want to be, the kind of artist that I want to be, I have to be completely honest. So I did. And I must say I was naive. I had no idea what it would entail, but I have no regrets, that's for sure.
Well, I have a question for you, because I wonder, now I'm sure Kids in the Hall were very popular, but what about the network you were working
on? It was a struggle every day, it definitely was. I mean, every day was like one step forward, 3 back.
Right.
But we were, the 5 of us together were such a monster in a way. Kind of a glorious monster, but we were. That there was such power and strength with the 5 of us that no one could really say no to us.
Because you were
always hard. did have, would make money and would make commercials. We never really became a huge commercial, right? But in many ways, that's the best thing of all. Like, you know, if I could tell the younger me, like, don't worry, like, you're never going to become gigantic that way, but it will give you more longevity. That's right. Because sometimes people get too much too soon and it ruins them. A lot of young comedians today, because of the nature of the internet, people are discovered before they're ready. And we came before that. So by the time we were on television, we'd only been together 5 years in the club. So we had our chance.
Yeah.
Bible.
Hi, I'm Scott Thompson.